Okay, so this is a comparison between the free Google Apps, which I have right now on the left, and the paid Google Apps, which is called G Suite, and it's on the right. So you've probably used the free app, so we're going to go over to the right. I'll maximize this so you can see this button. The apps that it offers in G Suite are pretty similar. They're in a different order, but most of them are the same. But if you scroll down, we're going to go through ones that are different. For example, I'm in the administrator account, and I can control some things that are only relevant if you're using G Suite. We'll go ahead and open up the admin console here and just do a brief overview of some of the things that are in here. You could spend all day going through all of them, but at a general level, you can control your users. So you can add and delete people here. If they leave the company, you can delete them right away so they can't log in and see their documents. And you can put them into groups. And groups are going to matter when you're doing things like using the calendar. Maybe you want to schedule a meeting with a group of people. Maybe you have different levels of staff that you want to put together. You can also control what apps people can use and see. So if you are married to Outlook at your organization, you don't want to give it up, just turn off Gmail here. You tell Google everything about your company. And here you can manage people's mobile devices. So if you don't want anyone accessing something through the phone, you can turn it off. And we'll delve into this a little bit more later. But for now, let's go to Gmail. And we're going to go back to seeing items on both screens. And I'm going to show you some of the differences here. The first thing, which is, I think, the biggest difference, and one basically that a lot of people pay for in and of itself, is that this email is not at gmail.com. This email that's free, it always has to be at Gmail. So you're kind of advertising for Google here with the free account, right? So they know that you're using Gmail. Here, it just looks like it's from a corporate account. Do you have to already have this domain name, or you could pay Google to register it for you? But you can't just pick anyone you want. So this one that I'm using happens to be the one that's written right here. And I own that domain. I registered it before. And when you join Google Suite, you just kind of attach it to that. The other important thing to know with Gmail, if you're using it in G Suite, previously you were using the email in Outlook or some IMAP services like Yahoo or an older Exchange server. You can use a data migration tool to bring those into here. You can bring in the email and the calendar and the contacts. So that'll get you started quickly. So if you do decide to use Google Suite, there's two different ways to pay for it. You can pay for it by month or the annual plan. And the annual plan is a bit of a discount, but if you add and remove users a lot, the flexible plan may be better for you. And if we come down here, the flexible plan is $5, $10, or $25, depending on which tier that you use. And we'll briefly go over the differences between these, but there's a lot of little details. Most often, if you're a smaller organization, the basic's going to be just fine. You can get a discount on these. If you look in the link for the video description, there's a link that you can use to get to the sign-up page, and then there's a code that can get you a discount for the first year, so you might want to look at that. And these different, what I called tiers, they like to call them editions. The different editions offer a couple of different things. So there's a comparison chart. And the biggest difference, and I think a lot of people run into, and they probably upgrade from basic to business, is that basic offers 30 gigs of storage. If you go out to business, it's unlimited. That's unlimited with an asterisk.
And we'll circle back to what that asterisk means in just a second.
The business and the enterprise features have things that are meant for e-discovery, might be for searching for documents if you're in a lawsuit, or if you need some far more granular controls, those are offered in the enterprise. There's no ads on any of this if you're paying for it. So keep those in mind. If we go back to comparing just the basic G Suite product to the free Google Apps, one of the differences is the amount of storage space. So when you have a free Google app, this is my free drive right here, it looks and feels mostly the same. But the free app is limited to 15 gigabytes, and the basic starts at 30 gigabytes. Now that 30 gigabytes does not include the native docs, sheets, slides, forms, etc. type apps. They don't take up a lot of space anyway, but if that's mostly what you have, those aren't even going to factor into this total. But it does include Gmail and the associated file attachments in those, so keep that in mind. And the storage space for business and enterprise, it says unlimited. It's pretty much unlimited, but if you have fewer than five people in your organization, each single person can't have more than a terabyte of information. Another big difference is that there's 24/7 support if you have G Suite, which can come into play if you're trying to do some more complicated things because you're at a company. Now, the one thing I had touched on already is you can make different group calendars. So if you have coworkers, you can go into the administration module, create a group, and then put those coworkers into different groups according to characteristics that are going to matter when you're scheduling meetings. So I'm going to left click on my calendar to create an event. And I'm already seeing two features that aren't in the free version. So you can set an out of office notification, and you can also create appointment slots. So what appointment slots do is it allows other people to go into your calendar and set an appointment with you. So think of something maybe like a professor making office hours. If we go to this calendar's appointment page, this would be the public facing side of it. And someone would come in here and try to schedule something with you. It says click on an appointment slot to sign up. If we go to some of the other apps, let's go to Google Docs, and Sheets and Slides are going to have some things that work the same way. I'm just going to open up a Google Doc here. And what this can do that it can't do in the free app is when you share it, if you click on Advanced, right now it's private, only I can access it, but I go to change that, I can set it to anyone at my organization. So that enables me with one click to share with anyone that I work with, or you could create a link that can only work for someone that's signed in to the organization's account. Either of these options are levels of control that can really come in handy when you have a company or an organization and you want to share files without worrying about someone from outside seeing them. And one of the more powerful features that G Suite offers is that you can manage mobile devices. Now you can see in this particular case, it's not enabled, but if it were relevant to me, I'd turn it on. But if it was turned on, you can choose when and if to activate someone's device, and you can control what apps they use, and you can do a remote wipe on them. So that's mobile device management. If we go back up to the Google Admin Console, they also have a lot of security features. Okay, so I'm using the basic edition of this. So I don't have access to the more advanced ones, but what I can do is control the way in which passwords are used and the login challenges, and you can do some single sign-on setup. There's a lot more granular security features that you can control and the higher accounts. And if you like that video and you want to see others just like it, you can subscribe in the lower right-hand corner. And if you want to be notified when other videos come out, you can click the bell. Thanks.